to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Great Power, Great Responsibility, written by M.K. Narayanan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is also important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the legitimacy, the justifiability and the credibility of India, due to which it should be getting assessed to the Security Council in United Nations. This editorial is also about how India will be getting a lot of responsibilities by entering into Security Council in United Nations. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to judge the issue of India's entry into Security Council from two perspectives. The first perspective is the perspective of credibility. And the second perspective is the perspective of legitimacy. Now, as far as legitimacy is concerned, now what is meant by legitimacy? Legitimacy means that it is justifiable, jayaz hai. Legitimacy means that India is a legitimate country, legitimate in terms of the people we are housing, in terms of the 17% of the world population that stays in India. Legitimacy in terms of the way we have dealt with any number of global issues. The issue of climatic change, the issue of immigration crisis in Bangladesh, the issue of the human rights crisis in Sri Lanka, the issue of the humanitarian help in Afghanistan, the issue of the boundary with respect to China and Pakistan. And we have acted very responsibly by accepting the dictates, by accepting the demands, by accepting the wishes of the global powers and the United Nations. We have accepted what the UN wants on the issue of boundary crisis with Pakistan. We have accepted UN's order with respect to Indus Water Treaty. We have accepted UN's order with respect to the Siachen crisis. We have accepted UN's order to play a proactive role in their peacekeeping missions. And India is a legitimate country. The way we have projected ourselves in the nuclear fora, the way we have carried ourselves in the nuclear realm, the way we have not undergone any clandestine trade with respect to nuclear technology. Now, Pakistan is a country which has acted very irresponsibly. The new Iran is again a country which was on the verge of to act irresponsibly. Now take the case of North Korea. It has also acted irresponsibly in terms of nuclear fora. But India has exhibited, India has displayed its sincerity, its credibility in the nuclear fora. Now, these are the reasons which provides a lot of legitimacy to India's cause for the entry in the Security Council. But there are also factors that proves to be illegitimate, like our procrastinating dispute with respect to boundary with Pakistan and with China. Now this dispute, it has become quite sustainable. It has been continuing since the days India was formed. We have not been able to solve this dispute. Now, like, this proves India's incapability of solving its own disputes. And how can we say that India will have the capacity and the capability to look for the global crisis and the global issues? But this is also true for countries like Russia, China, United States of America, France. They are also, and England even, they are also having their problem with other countries. This should not be dissuading, this should not be stopping India's entry into Security Council. But this is a kind of an illegitimate thing. that is hindering India's entry into the Security Council. Now, because of this, India's entry is dictated, India's entry is disputed by China and by Pakistan. And Russia is also not offering the help freely. We are getting a restricted and constricted help from Russia. Now, India has been a dormant part till now. Now, India wants to play up a proactive role with respect to the global terrorism, with respect to the WTO issue, with respect to the trade issue, with respect to the humanitarian help that it wants to offer. Now, India also wants to play up a proactive role in the domain of the social and the human development. Now, these two domains are something in which India can really invest a lot, in which India can offer a lot of help to the world. Now, as far as the credibility is concerned, India has a lot of credibility, the way it has helped the developing countries to fight for their cause in WTO. India has a lot of credibility, the way it has helped the developing countries to fight for their rights in discussing about the climatic talks. India holds a lot of credibility, the way it has acted during non-aligned movement. It has helped a number of countries to get independence. It has helped a number of countries to project their sovereignty. It has helped a number of countries to maintain their autonomy. So, India should be exhibiting more of this if it wants to attain the status. India should act more responsibly with respect to the Nepal crisis. India should be more proactive in dealing with the climatic change issue. India should be more proactive in dealing with the boundary issue with Pakistan and China. But India will be getting n number of responsibilities if it will be offered this permanent seat in the Security Council. The responsibilities will be taken care of with a lot of finance, with a lot of human effort, and with a lot of ingenuity, which India believes it possesses, but it has actually to show it to the world. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information of the classes that we're offering, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.